A normal distribution is a probability distribution for a continuous random variable that has a bell shape and is symmetric, like you see here. When it is drawn, the y-axis is rarely included because the area under the distribution curve is used more than the values on the y-axis. Its shape, how high it is, so to speak, and its location depend on two things, the mean and the standard deviation. For instance, here are two normal distributions graphed together. The red one has a higher peak and the green one is more spread out. They both have the same mean, but the green one has a larger standard deviation, making it more spread out. There are some important properties of a normal distribution. Number one is that the mean, median, and mode are equal and are located at the center of the distribution. Number two, its curve is bell-shaped and symmetric about the mean. So if we draw a line down the middle, the shape and area is the same on both sides of the line. Number three is that the curve is continuous, meaning that it goes on forever and never touches the x-axis. Number four is that the total area under the normal distribution curve is equal to 1. This may seem wrong as the curve never touches the x-axis, but it can be proven using calculus, which we're not going to do in this video. Number five is that the empirical rule applies to a normal distribution curve, and it states that about 68% of the area under the curve lies within one standard deviation of the mean. Within one standard deviation means one standard deviation to the left and one to the right. So about 68% of the area lies between negative 1 and positive 1 standard deviation. Since we know the shapes and areas are the same on both sides of the mean, we can divide 68% in half to get 34% on both sides. The empirical rule also states that about 95% of the area under the curve lies within 2 standard deviations of the mean. Within 2 standard deviations means 2 standard deviations to the left and 2 to the right. Since we know the shapes and areas are the same on both sides of the mean, we can divide 95% in half to get 47.5% on both sides. The empirical rule also states that about 99.7% of the area under the curve lies within 3 standard deviations of the mean. Again, within 3 standard deviations means 3 standard deviations to the left and 3 to the right. Since we know the shapes and areas are the same on both sides of the mean, we can divide 99.7% in half to get 49.85% on both sides. And we can break these areas down further by doing some subtraction. Let's look at just the right side for now. We have 47.5% from the mean to 2 standard deviations and 34% from the mean to 1 standard deviation. If we subtract 34 from 47.5, we get 13.5. And that would be the percentage of area between 1 and 2 standard deviations. We can do the same for the area between 3 standard deviations and 2 standard deviations. 49.85 minus 47.5 equals 2.35. So 2.35% of the area lies between 2 and 3 standard deviations. Again, since we know the shapes and areas are the same on both sides of the mean, we can apply these percentages to the left side of the mean. The two biggest things to remember about the normal distribution curve is that the area under the curve is equal to 1, and the empirical rule of 68%, 95%, and 99.7% in regards to the mean and standard deviation. Both of these concepts are extremely important. All right, my friends, that be the basics on the normal distribution. Hopefully you got something out of this video. I do have more videos right there for you. Till next time, I am out of here.